Hello, my name is Brian Schulz. I'm the district treasurer of the West Seneca Central School District. Welcome to our schools. Most people think that during the summer months, school buildings are closed. Over the next 30 minutes, I'd like to introduce you to some of the people and programs that run during the summer months. Terry Brancato, our Director of Community Education, helped coordinate and run the LEAP program at West Elementary this summer.
One of the programs that is very popular in the summertime is the Leap into Learning program. And it's an enrichment program for children from grades 1 through 5. We have almost 100 kids in this summer, and it's going quite well. The larger amount of children obviously are in the lower grades, but we still get a good cross-section of kids in the 4th and 5th grades. And they're getting a little bit of a taste of what they're going to get in the coming school year, so it gives them a little bit of a leg up.
It's a 4-week program. 4 days a week, Monday through Thursday, 9 to noon, so the children are able to come in, do some academic learning while having some fun. We do get outside and do a little bit of playing during those hours. However, the children still have a summer left because it's a 4-week program, and they're also out by noon, so they can go home and have lunch with their families and still do their swimming lessons and, you know, all the other wonderful things the community has to offer. The children arrive in the morning, and the first thing they do is we do give them a little bit of computer time. Then they do some journal writing, because that's part of the ELA program that the state is requiring, is that the children do a lot of writing. And we do some sharing of their journals, which incorporates the ELA standards of reading and writing and speaking, and we work on the listening also. The children then move into some stretching. Young children don't sit long, so we like to keep them up and keep them moving. So then we move into some activities. As you can see, the children today are working on some seasonal things, and they're cutting and pasting and gluing, and also socializing and having time to talk with other classmates and make new friends. I hope that with the 4 weeks that the students spend together, first of all, that they are a little bit more comfortable heading into their new grade level. They've experienced some reading, some math, some writing, and the grade level that they're headed into. So I'm hoping they go into that grade level a little bit more comfortable. Second of all, I hope they have fun, because there's nothing better than having fun and learning at the same time. And I think third of all, I hope they meet a new friend. Some great friendships come out of these community programs, because the kids go to all of the different schools throughout the district, and now we're bringing them all together. And some kids from Winchester and Clinton and West Elementary and Potters, they're all here together, and they're starting to make plans to do things together and wanting to exchange phone numbers. So it brings the community together here in one setting.
Here in community education, we provide year-long classes. We have classes 4 seasons out of the year. So when you normally think that the school district is closed and the buildings are being cleaned, we're here providing other opportunities for your children and for yourself to learn a little bit more in the summertime. Some recreational programs that you may not have had the time to do during the year. And we've got, I think just what you need. Come and look at us, and we've got plenty of things to offer for you.
With the higher emphasis on state standards and student performance, the West Seneca Teacher Center has taken a lead role in this school district in providing training to our teachers. As a board member of the West Seneca Teachers Board, I'm proud to introduce Debbie Stazek to walk you through some of the programs in the West Seneca Teacher Center.
Hi, my name is Debbie Stazek. I'm the director of the Teacher Center here in West Seneca Central School District. I'm here to tell you about our Teacher Center and a bit about what our teachers here in West Seneca do during the summer months. People sometimes have the misconception that teachers spend their summer months lounging and really taking a break from their teaching and learning activities. I'm here to tell you a different story. I'm here to tell you what the teachers in West Seneca do during the summer months. First of all, let me tell you a little bit about our teachers' annual renewal option, something we refer to as ARO. Our teachers here in West Seneca are mandated to take at least 15 additional hours of in-service every year to make sure that their skills are sharpened and they continue to improve their teaching strategies to help to teach their students learn in the classroom. This summer alone, we offered through our center 93 courses for our teachers to take. The courses encompass four different goal areas. The first goal area is an area that we refer to as children at risk. And in this area, we have courses such as dealing with the learning disabled child, understanding central auditory processing disorder, behavior management, classroom management, strategy, crisis intervention. This area also encompasses eating disorders in adolescents and school-aged children, depression in children, and the list goes on and on. That's only scratching the surface. Our next area is professional growth and teaching techniques. This area focuses on instructional strategies that teachers use in the classroom. If you're familiar with the movement that our state education has taken in raising the standards and raising that bar for all of our students, including our special ed population, you would know the skills required by our teachers to help our students meet those needs. In this area, we offer programs such as study skills, differentiated instruction, designing rubrics, constructivism, also looping, cooperative learning, action research, and gap analysis, again, just to name a few. Our third area is one we call curriculum enhancement and resources. And this area focuses on the specific curricular areas. We offer courses for our music teachers. We have courses in math. We have a new math program starting here in West Seneca called Everyday Math. The training takes place right here at our center. We have an extensive science training program that is offered in the summer months as well as during the school year. We have an extensive selection of courses offered in the area of reading and writing and work in cooperation with the Western New York Writing Project to bring that to our staff. Our last but certainly not least area is that of technology. We have a brand new iMac computer lab here at the center, which is used for most of the training within our district. And we offer an extensive array of courses, beginning with very simple courses like basic Mac skills, where we teach individuals how to turn on a computer, show them what the keyboard is, just learning the parts of the computer and some very basic skills, to very advanced courses in designing their own web page and home page construction. For those of you who don't know, our center is basically two rooms here at the administration building, which is housed at West Elementary within our district. But I really make every effort to take our teachers outside of those walls, and the summer months allows me to do that. We have teachers taking courses throughout Western New York. We have four fabulous programs that are running at the Botanical Gardens, which focus on science, plants, deserts, rainforest, temperate zone. We've had courses take place at the Birchfield Center right here in West Seneca. And one of our very popular courses is our CDOS course, which is a career development course where groups of teachers go out to industries, businesses, medical sites throughout Western New York and beyond to explore the world of work. This particular course enables the teachers to go out into the world of work and see the kind of skills that are required for their students once they leave us. And that certainly is our responsibility to make sure that they have the skills needed. And this is a very useful program for our teachers. We have a very large amount of equipment here at our center. We have things such as poster makers, poster printers, laminators, our computer lab, which is open to the teachers at any time to access. Possibly they don't have a computer at home or don't have a Mac computer at home, which is what we use here in West Seneca. They're free to come into the lab and to use that. You might be thinking, after all that I've told you, this has to cost a lot of money. And you're right. These types of programs and materials are extremely expensive. But this is the beauty of teacher centers. Teacher centers are a very special initiative that came about through a cooperative effort between the State Education Department and NYSET. Most of the money that we use at our center and all the centers in New York State are attained through grants supplied by the State Education Department. We also do receive some funding from the district that is specifically earmarked for staff development projects, as all of the coursework that I have mentioned to you. And also to offset the cost, because it still costs more than even that can provide, our teachers pay for the courses that they take. They pay $3 a credit hour for every course that they take here at the center in West Seneca. The benefits of teacher centers are countless, and for this reason it is important for us to continue receiving the funding we do from state ed. And I may have failed to mention earlier that this isn't something that's a given. It is renewed on a yearly basis. Every year I need to write a grant proposal requesting funds from the State Education Department and hoping that that is included in the state budget. I must say that our local legislators here in this area have been extremely supportive of teacher centers and all that we do for our staff, which in turn affects our children, which is what it's all about.
Over the summer, we have over 100 civil service employees working in the buildings and grounds area. Jim Heinberg, the superintendent of buildings and grounds, will outline some of the practices and work that needs to be done to prepare our schools for a September 4th school opening.
Thanks, Brian. Buildings and grounds is in fact one of the busiest departments in the district during the summertime, and we have a lot of things to do to prepare for all of our students to return in September. A couple of the things that we do is to support some of the programs that go on in the summertime, and even though people think our buildings are empty, they certainly aren't. We run a program for many of our physically and mentally challenged students that's operated through the Erie One BOCES program, and our West Middle School was host to that this year. And at the very same time, we're preparing rooms for the next September season. So we have to do both while we're trying to run that program. But as we clean a building for the next year, we clean every piece of furniture in every single room. And that includes every desk, every chair, every bookcase, every file cabinet. We dust the room top to bottom. Our custodial staff goes into the room and scrubs the floor, and then we re-wax those floors so that the room is shiny and prepared for the following year. We do that in every single space in the school district. That requires our cleaners and custodial staff to work in full cooperation with each other, and it's a team effort so that we can finish everything in time for the start of school. To assist in this project, we hire many young people who are students of our school district. They are either in high school in their later years, junior, senior, as well as students who are in their first, second year of college. Now these students all come and work for the school district. We allow them to work, and they get to make a little money, and we in turn get their help for the work that we're doing over the summer. So it's a great assistance for us. We include them in our grounds department as well as in our buildings to help. So it's a good program for everybody. And we certainly couldn't do all the work we do without their help. Additionally, many of the supplies that are needed to operate a school year will come in over the summertime. These supplies are many times delivered either to a particular building or to one site, and then they're distributed around the school district. Many of the things that come in are paper towels and toilet tissue and garbage bags and paper products that teachers and faculty need to just use for just common white paper. Our print shop uses huge amounts of paper in preparation for the school year. All these things come in, and our staff in buildings and grounds take and distribute those materials out to the school so that they have what they need to operate a program. It's not only cleaning that we do and distribution of supplies. There's also the aspect of maintenance during the summertime. Now, during that particular time, we go through and change filters and take care of many of our routine problems. But additionally, this year, we added a couple of things that were helpful and necessary for the start of this school year. We added two classrooms over at the West Elementary School. They were administrative offices. Those were changed, and they'll become classrooms. And we'll have two new classrooms now available for the student enrollment at West Elementary. Also, in three of our school buildings, we modified lavatories so that we're now completely handicap accessible. We did lavatories at Allendale Elementary, Clinton Elementary, and at Potter Elementary. We also made a modification at Northwood so that now people who come into our buildings have better access to an already handicapped accessible lab, but it's now more available to the general public. So there's many things that we do in maintenance as well to go along with all these other things. So buildings and grounds is pretty active, and summertime can be one of our most active times.
Allendale Elementary School hosted our summer reading and math program this year. John Todoroff was the principal of the program and will fill us in on the purpose of these programs.
Hello, my name is John Todoroff. I'm the Director of Language Arts, Social Studies, and Library Media Centers in the West Seneca Central School District. This summer, we are engaged in a summer reading and math program for students in West Seneca that have exhibited at-risk tendencies in grades 1 through 4. Currently, they've been struggling. We've identified them through diagnostic measures that they need to improve their basic skills in reading, reading comprehension, sound symbol relations, advancement of prior knowledge, their print book knowledge, and last but not least, their calculation and computation ability in mathematic problem solving. Our program began July 9th and will run through August 8th. We run from 8 in the morning until noon. We have approximately 213 students this year with a staff of 20 professional staff members. We have a full-time librarian, full-time nurse, full-time clerk to handle all of the school-related events and activities that go on inside and outside of the classroom.
Take a look at the shapes and think about the definition of congruent, what we've talked about. What does it mean for something to be congruent? Do you remember? Sarah?
If you fold the diamond in half or cut it in straight in the middle and put it on top of the other side and it's the same, that means it's congruent.
Okay, we've got, if you took a line of symmetry and they would match exactly, those would be symmetrical.
My co-teacher, Mrs. Gallagher, takes a stance at the front board as I read the questions to the children. She engages them in getting them to brainstorm and think of different mathematical ideas such as greater than and less than, symmetry and congruency, parts of a table and a chart. We try to give them as much information as we can to get them focused and to think about their prior knowledge that they have in mathematics and to get them real involved and interested in the concept and the themes working on for the day.
Can this powwow last forever?
Popcorn seller.
When the children read out loud, they get a chance to pick the next person to read, so everybody can have a turn to read. We call it popcorn reading. One person starts and they popcorn another person in the class. These children do not have the anxiety, whereas before, in years before, it was called rote reading, and they would know when they were going to be called on to read next, and they'd be so concerned about the part that they were reading that they wouldn't listen to the other kids reading. They do have the choice to pass, however, but they love popcorn reading so much that they want to be called, so nobody ever passes.
Our summer reading program this year focuses on very, very basic skill development in reading, reading comprehension, sound symbol relationships, math calculation, problem solving. We are convinced that the students that we have in the program that were selected based on their performance in their last academic year need to develop at that basic skill level. We focus with a very, very rigorous round of activities on a day-to-day basis, focus on those skills that need development and need improvement. We don't like to think that our summer reading program is so crammed filled with additional schoolwork that it might frustrate a child. We actually very carefully tailor the program so that the child meets success every day and they feel a sense of accomplishment. And we walk them through a very systematic approach toward development in those basic reading skills and those basic math skills. Our hope is that they will enter their next grade level with a better sense of accomplishment, a better feeling of ability, and we think that they'll have a much better academic year following this very short 23-day program, but intensive program. With the support of the parents, providing a half an hour to 45 minutes of homework reading time in the evening or afternoon, with our 4 hours of activity in the school day, we really think we can make a difference in the child's academic career.
Believe it or not, one of the busiest spots in our school district during the summer is the transportation building. We clean our buses, we train our staff, and we prepare our routing for the next year. Larry Kaminsky will lead you through some of the procedures that we handle during the summer.
Hello, I'm Larry Kaminsky. I'm the transportation director here at West Seneca Schools, and I'm joined here today with my head bus driver, Kevin Love, and I've asked him to kind of go over a little bit of what we do during the course of the summer. Many times people have asked me what we do over the course of the summer. most apparent is our summer school routing, in which we're, for this year, transporting approximately 350 students using about 28 routes to do so. That's been taking place on a daily basis. Behind the scenes, it generally becomes our most busy time of the year when we're dealing with the amount of student changes that we have in effect. Now again, one of the reasons in which I've asked Kevin to join me today was to kind of go into more detail on what we do during the course of our summer with regards to the routing.
Routing for the summer, we start in April. According to state education guidelines, parochial and private school students are supposed to have applied to the district by April 1st of each year to have transportation taken to the private parochial schools. This year we were quite fortunate that we took the proactive stance and we reminded all the parents that, one, they needed to apply by the April 1st deadline, and we've also sent out proactively a child care letter reminding all the parents of private parochial by the April 1st deadline, and even public school students by the June 15th deadline as board policy, that if they intend to have the children go to a child care location, that it's due at that time. We were very fortunate 4 or 5 years ago, I believe 5 years ago, that the district invested in a computerized routing program that we've been able to utilize. Last year we implemented it, and we did have some problems at the beginning of the school year last year, but we worked through those bugs. And this year, we're in full implementation of the program, and we're very much farther ahead than we ever have in the past. We've been able to this year provide all students in private parochial and the public schools a transportation routing card that we affectionately is known as the yellow card that we mailed out. We mailed out all the high school students a card this year, which we'd never been able to do in the past just because of the timing. We received the data from within the school district this year at the beginning of June, which helped a lot. We've processed that data and we've been able to send all these cards out 2 weeks prior to what we normally have in the past.
We give our district resident students the opportunity to work to make money over the course of the summer washing our vehicles. This one behind us as we stand here is one example of the job that they've done. They've done everything inside and out, scrubbing the bus, getting the grease off, getting the gum off the floors, cleaning the seats, et cetera, preparing them for the next regular school year. They're working 6 to 7 hours per day, 5 days a week.
This is an example of one of the buses in which we've taken some major repairs up with during the course of the summer. DOT requires that there is no corrosion to be on our vehicles. In this case, we had such major corrosion on this vehicle and still some life expectancy left in the vehicle, so we've chosen to replace each of these panels rather than repair it. The time savings in which we've had versus the temporary repairs and patching corrosion will be a payoff for us in the future with this vehicle, but as you can see, a very massive undertaking in which we've taken up with this bus in the panel repairs. The main goal of the transportation department in West Seneca Schools is to provide safe and efficient transportation for the students of the district. We use the summer as, again, a refresher for ourselves, as well as a time to make sure that that all happens.
Thank you for watching this edition of Our Schools. We hope you found this show informative and have learned a little bit about what goes on in the school system during the summer months. Thank you.